Let's do this problem right here. The question is asking, determine the force that the jaws of the metal cutters exert on the smooth cable C. So this is this cable C, and this is what we have to find. So let's separate this part first. So if I draw this part, so we have this one right here, and that's what we have. So we have to find this force acting on this. Also, if you see this one, this one is a true force member. This one is going to have force right here, let's say FC. So also the same force is going to act from other side. So both of them are equal. So if we find one of them, we are fine. Therefore, if I take this one, so let's say this is FC, that's what we have to find out. And also if you see E has a straight pin joint straightly vertical. So I know that we are going to have a vertical force right there. Let's call this one EY. The direction, you can pick any direction you want. The answers give the real direction. Let's go further. And if you see A is a three force member. It's going to have a force right here, force right here. So we don't know exactly the directions we can solve. Therefore, we can put two forces. Let's call this one AY. This is AX. So if the directions are just the assumption. And when you calculate, if you get the negative answer, it means your assumption is wrong and the direction is opposite. That's how we find it out. And in this case, if you see, we don't have any information to find any of these things. We don't have any force given or anything, right? So what we have to do is we have to do to the top, and let's move to this one and figure it out if we can find anything. So I'm going to draw that part. So this is my diagram of this one. So let's draw this all the way. Okay, so we have a pin right here. This is the A, and also we have something, a pin right here. And actually it's something right here. And also they have given that 100 Newton acting vertically toward this. And they have given the angle that's making with the vertical to the object is 15 degree. And same thing right here. It's this is vertical. So let's put the forces first. So in the machines, so when you put the forces, if you separate this part, the force is going to be exactly opposite direction according to Newton's third law. If you take the AX in this direction here, you have to put it here in the opposite direction. So it's going to be AX in this direction, and AY is going to be acting downside. So that's how we calculate this one. And let's go further. And also this is with the machine, vertical to the machine, it's making 15 degree. And also they have given the distance between these two joints is 20 millimeter. So it's going like this, 20 millimeter. And that's all the information we have. And also this distance is given, that's 400 millimeter. From here also we have F. So F is a pin, so it's going to have two forces. Let's call this one FY, FX. So which information we find out will be helpful to find this one? If you find one of these AX or AY, that will be really helpful, right? Because that's what we want to, because we want to move to this part. We don't have to anything to deal with FY or anything. So what I can do is, if I take the moment around F, I can cancel these two forces and eliminate this one and find these things. So let's take this one, moment around F equal to zero in statics. And if I take counterclockwise positive and solve for this one, let's see what are the moments we're going to have. So in this case, if I take AY in the horizontal axis, if I take in the vertical axis, what's going to happen? This is along this axis, because and also one thing to remember that when we take the movement, that should be exactly perpendicular to the object. We can't take this one directly straight vertical or something like that. We have to make this one perpendicular to the object, then we calculate the movement that's making. That's how we do that. So in this case, to make this one perpendicular to the object, I had to take cos 15 to take vertical, but vertical is not going to create any movement, because if you see, the pin joint are like straight, right? So it's not going to create any movement. But if I take horizontal sine 15, that's going to push this object in the counterclockwise direction. So let's do this. Ay sine 15 is going to create counterclockwise, so it's going to be positive, and the distance is 20 millimeter. 20, you don't have to put the sign, so 20 millimeter. And then what I had to do is I had to calculate this one. 100 also going to create movement, but before I do that, I had to make it to perpendicular to this object. So cos 415 is pulling this object down. It means it's acting clockwise, so it's going to be negative. Negative cos 100 cos 15. Was 15, and the distance is 400 millimeter, so time 400. And also we are going to have a horizontal movement on this one, so horizontal movement is sine 15. So if you see, this is sine 15 is going to be along this direction, so it means pushing this object clockwise. So clockwise mean it's going to be positive, so plus 100 sine 15, and the distance is 20 millimeter, so times 20. And these are the things, the only things, because ax is basically ay sine 15 is the horizontal force, so we don't have to calculate differently with ax and stuff like that. We only have to do it once, and this is equal to 0. And then what's going to happen is, if I solve for ay comes out to be, so let's calculate these things. Since this is the value, ay, if you solve for, if you move this one to the other side, this will give you 38119.39. Then if you divide this one by 20 sine 50, because I am taking the fault parts to the other side first, then I am dividing this one by these things, 20 sine 15, that is going to give you 7364 8.1, and that's the value I am getting right here. So let's plug it in the, yeah, let's check it one more time. So 38119.39 divided by 20 sine 15 is equal to 736.41. So this is 1. Let me calculate again. 38119.39 divided by 20 sine 15. It's giving us 7364.61. So this is the value I'm getting. Then let's move to the other side. The purpose is to find FC. So we have AY, and that's the only thing we have to know, because I'm going to take movement around E, because E is something unnecessary. And if I take movement around E, the AX also will be eliminated, because it's not going to create any movement because it's along the axis. So we only need to know AY and FC, and the distance is provided right here. The distance between this is 30 millimeter, and distance between EY and the B is, no, EY and the A is 80 millimeter. So we have known these two information. So I can take the movement around E. So if I take movement around E, it's equal to 0 in statics. And if I solve this one, let's see what happens. I'm taking counterclockwise positive. And then AY is going to push this object counterclockwise, so it's going to be positive. AY times 80. And then we have FC also pushing this object in the clockwise, so it's going to be negative. FC times 30 equal to 0. These are the only two forces that creating movement around E. So now we can calculate FC. So 30 FC is equal to 80 AY. 80 times this number 7364.1. Then to calculate FC, I can divide this one by 30. 80 times 7364.1 divided by 30. So let's calculate this one. 80 times 7364.1 divided by 30 is giving us 19637.6 newton. So this is the final answer. Since the answer is coming positive, this means the direction is correct. So exactly, the FC is going to act exactly in this direction, and this is the final answer. So we can state it like this: FC is equal to 19637.6 newton, and that's the final answer. I hope you guys like this video. See you next time.